Finally, recycling. Again, linked to all these other things. Why? Because without the energy price being high, the logic of recycling would fall. As we know, because energy is such a huge component of manufacturing costs. So we recycle metal and we save 70% of energy, we save 40% water. Once again, we're linking water, energy, commodities together. We can't separate them. Just want to look at car recycling because I think it's a fascinating area and a rapidly growing and highly specialized. I don't think we've even begun to see a fraction of the mechanization, sophistication, automation of this area. There will be at least 9 million end-of-life vehicles a year in the EU soon. 42% of all cars are made already from recycled metal. We think, well, we have the technology, as you know, to get to at least 95% of all material recycled. 6 million cars a year being sold in China means that soon they will have the same decommissioning problem. We have already in the world today more steel recycled than would build 150 Eiffel Towers a year. And yet, at the same time, we see political pressures. So people don't want the messy recycling in their backyards, so please put it in Hungary, where labor is cheaper and the ecological pressures are less. Or let's fill empty containers and send 3 million EU cars back to China and see what they can do with them. I think this is a fascinating area. I've talked to many of my friends about the technologies used in recycling cars, the things which you take for granted, because this is your industry. But most consumers don't realize that you can shred a car into tiny pellets of steel and plastic and automatically sort them on conveyor belts at 40 kilometers per hour into 18 different kinds of recycled material with unimaginable benefits for everyone except the second-hand component industry. Once again, it's interesting that recycling of materials has, in one way, proved itself to be environmentally unfriendly, because if you are on a low income and your headlight has broken, perhaps the first thing you want to do is go to a yard where there are many old cars and to get an old headlight off it. But of course, the manufacturers are wanting to shred all the old components, even if they work perfectly, to prevent them from coming back into the market. And just finally, one final thought is this, and again, I think this is a fascinating area, again, where we've seen these technologies come together. You know, the massive, massive problem of old tires for cars. But now we have the most fantastic solutions, wonderful solutions, which you are using and other companies are using to gasify this rubber and to turn it into clean fuel, to make electricity, to produce carbon black and pure steel at the end of the process. Wonderful. I think it's just another example of extraordinary, innovative, dynamic, agile engineering, cutting-edge technologies which will help to transform our future.